Welcome back to our series on visualization, identification, and estimation in the linear panel event strat design. In this video, I will introduce heterogeneous policy effects to our model. So let me start by repeating our model and our equation of interest here. We observe a panel data set where the outcome variable of interest is going to be denoted by yit. Alpha I and gamma t denote unit and time-specific fixed effects. Qit are observed covariates. Zit is our policy variable. Note that it enters with leads and lags, such that we allow for dynamic policy effects. The epsilon IT is a standard error term that we are going to largely ignore throughout. It's well behaved. The CIT here denotes a confound, which may be related to both the policy and the outcome variable of interest, and is generally going to be unobserved. Throughout our series, we have so far maintained homogeneous policy effects, both in the sense that our DGPs all have had homogeneous policy effects, and that the estimators we considered were designed for such homogeneous policy effects. In this video, we relax both of these limitations. Throughout, in line with the large and rapidly growing literature in this field, I will focus on a setting of staggered adoption, that is, a binary policy variable with an absorbing state. Let me also define a unit's cohort as the period in which that unit adopts the policy. That out of the way, the first way in which we can introduce heterogeneous policy effects here is by letting the causal effect vary by cohort, which again is going to be denoted by a T star. That means our DGP can be written as the cohort specific effects DGP on this slide, with coefficients beta now depending on the cohort T star. It also means that we can run a regression of this very equation here and all previously discussed approaches to identification that we discussed in our videos on identification should be able to recover the causal effects, which now of course also depend on the cohort T star. So we get a whole set of estimates, basically T star separate estimates for the dynamic treatment effects, one for each cohort, and then we can average those if needed. In a few slides, I will show you in simulations that this approach actually works very well. Now, alternatively, causal effects may vary by unit I. In that case, if I estimate a regression corresponding to the cohort-specific effects equation that I had on the previous slide, the resulting estimates may not give a proper weighted average of the unit-specific policy effects for units in that cohort. And in general, to recover a proper weighted average is only possible in special cases. So let me give you some examples of such special cases next. Suppose assignment is completely random. So cohort and thus treatment is assigned independently of all variables in the model, including the treatment effects for a unit. Then a standard homogeneous to a fixed effect estimator using a regression corresponding to the homogeneous estimating equation depicted on the slide will actually estimate a proper weighted average of the unit specific policy effects. Another special case is one where there are no dynamics in the treatment and there are no controls or confounds. Then a standard homogeneous two-way fixed effects estimator using a regression corresponding to the homogeneous effects equation again depicting here, will again estimate a proper weighted average of the unit-specific policy effects. Now as a third example, suppose there are no controls or confounds and some never treated units. Then a two-way fixed effects estimator applied to the cohort-specific estimating equation that's shown here is a valid estimate of a proper weighted average of the unit-specific policy effects, beta I, for units in the corresponding cohort. Now, the common theme in the previous special cases was that it ruled out most forms of confounding. In particular, it ruled out the types of confounding that we consider in our paper. Now, our view is that many economic settings will probably exhibit both confounding and some heterogeneous policy effects. So further developing approaches that are robust to both seems like a promising area for future research. Today, I will suggest one approach in this direction. And to do so, I will turn to a simulation exercise next and highlight the performance of different approaches under a number of DGPs we think are pretty reasonable approximations to some economic settings of interest. So I will explore what happens when we add heterogeneous policy effects in these simulations in three ways. First, I will explore the performance of estimators that are designed to be robust to treatment heterogeneity under DGPs with homogeneous policy effects. Second, I will explore the performance of estimators that are designed to be robust to confounding under heterogeneous DGPs. And then finally, I will suggest an extension of the estimators that are designed to be robust to confounding that is also robust to treatment heterogeneity. And I'll explore the performance of this extension in DGPs that have both confounding and treatment heterogeneity. Now, to recap the DGPs we consider, the first row here depicts the event time path of the outcome. And it does so for four different DGPs. This video series also includes a more detailed video on the simulation setup. And so for more details on these DGPs, I would refer you to that video titled Simulations. In that video, we also discuss our simulation results in more detail in a world with homogeneous policy effects. Now, importantly, the black line here depicts the treatment effect for each of these, depicts a true treatment effect. So for this first set of simulations, the treatment is both homogeneous and static in all four DGPs. So in all four columns, you have the same treatment effect here. In red, you see that what you see depicted here is the 5th, 50th, and 95th percentile of the point estimates for the event time path across many simulations. So what you see in the first row here is that there is significant confounding going on. A standard two-way fixed effect estimator is severely biased, both in terms of pre-trends and in its estimate for the treatment effect post-event. So you see that the median estimate here is far from the black line, both pre-event as well as post-event. And this is true for all four DGPs that we consider here. Now, the bottom row takes those same DGPs, again, with homogeneous and static treatment effects indicated by the black line, and applies an estimator to it that is designed to be robust to heterogeneous policy effects. And what you see is that the resulting estimates in the second row are almost identical to the simple two-way fixed effects estimate in all four DGPs. And so they're still severely biased. Of course, that is not particularly surprising here. The reason the two-way fixed effects estimator is biased is because of confounding and not heterogeneous policy effects, because there are no heterogeneous policy effects. In our paper, we consider a couple of alternative estimators that are also designed to be robust to heterogeneity in policy effects, and the results are very similar. So next, we actually add heterogeneous policy effects to our DGP. So now the treatment effect differs by unit. In particular, we generate two different policy effects, and earlier cohorts are more likely to be assigned to the larger policy effect. So there's some systematic difference between cohorts here, even though the policy effect actually differs by unit. Now, in such a world, we again first consider our standard two-way fixed effects estimator, and that is depicted in the first row here. So here we have zeroed in on one of our DGPs, and then in each of these four columns here, we vary the treatment effects, again depicted by the black lines. So in the first column, we have a static homogeneous treatment effect that is the same as we had before. In the second column over here, we have a static but heterogeneous treatment effect. So some units are effectively treated with a treatment effect of zero, while others have a sort of static treatment effect here. In the third column, we have homogeneous treatment effects that are dynamic. So the treatment effect builds up over time here. And in the final column, we combine those two, and we have heterogeneous effects. Some units are actually experience a policy effect of zero, and others have this dynamic treatment effect going on. Okay, so what we see here is that under heterogeneous treatment effects, our standard two-way fixed effects estimator produces an estimate that is outside the convex hull of the two treatment effects, right? So if you focus on this last figure over here, for example, you see that the median estimate is outside the convex hull of the two treatment effects. Now in the second row, we then consider an alternative estimator, in this case, one of our IV estimators for the policy. In this particular DGP, this estimator, which is essentially just two SLS, should give us a consistent estimate of the true causal effect under homogeneous policy effect. Of course, we wouldn't necessarily expect it to be robust to heterogeneous policy effects though. And so indeed, we see that it performs well in the two cases with homogeneous policy effects. So this is the columns 1 and 3 here. But it doesn't perform particularly well in the two columns that have heterogeneous policy effects. So columns 2 and 4. So there we see some median bias creep in. And in particular, we note sort of mild pre-trends over here and over here in both figures. Now, finally, And I already alluded to this, we are going to explore estimating cohort-specific treatment effects directly by estimating our cohort-specific estimating equation that I'm repeating over here. So essentially the way to do this is we just interact the policy variables with indicators for cohort. Estimating this equation can clearly happen not just by two-way fixed effects, but also using any of the other estimators we discussed in our videos on identification, which are designed to be to adequately capture the confound depending on the assumptions. In the end, we again are just going to average across cohorts to get a single estimated event study path for the figures I'm going to show you next. So if we do that, we get the following picture. In the first row, we run our cohort-specific estimating equation with two-way fixed effects. Because of the confounding, we again see a significant median bias here, irrespective of whether the treatment effects are heterogeneous or not. In the case with treatment heterogeneity, so again, columns sort of 2 and 4 here, that again means we actually leave the convex hull of the treatment effects for the median estimate, right? So this median estimate is again outside of the two black lines. Now in the bottom now, we use an instrumental variable approach to estimate our cohort-specific estimating equation. Since that equation can accommodate cohort-specific treatment effects, and our IV approach can adequately control for the confound here, we see that we obtain a median unbiased estimate in the homogeneous case. So over here and over here, you see a very mild bias maybe creeping in, but you're essentially unbiased. And you obtain an estimate that is inside the convex hull, so some proper weighted average in the heterogeneous case. So to conclude our discussion of treatment effect heterogeneity, our findings highlight that addressing the possibility of confounding and addressing the possibility of heterogeneous policy effects are not substitute for one another. Further, in settings with severe confounding, estimators designed to recover proper weighted averages of heterogeneous policy effects under no confounding can perform poorly. Likewise, in settings with limited or no confounding, but significant heterogeneity in policy effects, those estimators that are motivated by models with homogeneous policy effects that do allow for confounding can also exhibit undesirable behavior such as spurious pretrends. And that brings us to the end of our series. Thanks so much for watching. All the material was based on the paper Visualization, Identification, and Estimation in the Linear Panel Event Study Design. You can find that paper on our websites together with our accompanying Stata package, which you can also download directly from SSC.